Hi Michael, nice to see you.
Hi.
I think you are just as excited for 6.3 as I am, and I see you're already sharing your screen. You told me you have something to show me.
Yes, I'd like to show you a really nice new feature of the ETS 6.3. We have also implemented in our product. And I'd like to show you first the project that I made using semantics and the building structure. And then we'll import the semantic export into our visualization. And at the end, the visualization will give you an output of all the group addresses that are used inside the visualization. And we will be able to copy and paste them just onto the secure interface of our product, which will make it very easy for you to set up the group addresses that are used on the tunnel. And you do not need to maintain any of those filter tables manually because everything will be just copy and paste and very easy to go.
I think we will see this now, why that is of benefit. Yes, I'm very
Yes,
excited.
yes. Okay, so let's see on our project. We have a nice small project. We have a few rooms on the left. We are using here the building tab. And I have a few rooms with a few devices, and we are using the new semantic functions. So we have the ceiling light, which is just a small light which we can switch on and off and which has a status address. We have some blinds, and we also have some dimmable light. And everything is just as the ETS created it. So the group addresses are automatically created. The naming is all the same. I have just connected the group addresses to the communication objects, to the devices. And that's all we need to do at the moment. And now I'd
Good.
like to show you how to export them. So we go here to the ETS and we want to click on export. That's where you would also export the whole project, but you will also have the chance to do the semantic export. And that's what we would like to do. The first one, the TTL, the turtle file export, that's the one we need to export. And it takes a couple of seconds.
Yeah.
And if we export the project in the semantic way, we will have a lot of more data than just the XML export file, which we are used since I think till ETS 6.1, which introduced the semantic export. And now we can use the new semantic export, and we'll just head over to SimCon. This is our visualization product, and you see here it's a web-based con.
This is now the SimCon web interface, right?
Yes, this is our product where you just configure your KNX part of the system, and you will be able to import the semantic file here. And we just apply the changes. And what we will see here is we have the same structure like in the ETS. It has already
Very
detected the
good.
function, and it has already detected the group addresses, which you see on the left, and the additional group addresses, meaning the status addresses, so you don't need to take care of that as well. And
And
all we
it
need,
got this
yes?
automatically. Yeah.
Yeah, that's just automatically because due to the semantic relations that are inside on the TTL file, we are able to auto-detect this type of status addresses.
Very
So
nice.
now we just create everything. And I'd like to show you how it looks like in our product in the visualization part. So we see here, it's the same structure like in the ETS. So if you use the building structure, it will be automatically created inside in the visualization. And you see here in the bathroom, we have a ceiling light, which we can switch on and off. And we have some blinds, which we can use. And we have the slats. So everything is auto-detected and usable. And the same here in the kitchen with the visualization of the dimmer. But that's not the feature we're here for. Just a quick review how fast we can use the semantic export to make a visualization.
Yeah,
But the
because
feature.
what's important now is, of course, because I saw this in ETS, you have secure groups, right? So you need to
Yes.
somehow get the keys, get the security key information, and what's important is the filter tables, right?
Yes, this is very important because maybe as you know, the other part, so the device that is switching on and off or is doing the dimming, it needs to know our product. So our product is the SimBox. It has a TP interface, so it has also a physical address. And the switching device needs to know our physical address on his part, And therefore, the ETS needs to properly program all those devices that we are allowed as a virtualization to communicate through the group address with the secure device. And
okay. How do we do that?
Yeah, so what we could do is just select every group address and just copy and paste it onto our secure interface. That's what we would have done before ETS 6.3, just copy and paste everything, better everything than nothing. But now we have a more sophisticated way, which I'd like to show you. So we could click on this here, and it will show you all the group addresses that are used inside our project. So everything that is imported. If we would just import part of the TTL file, it would just show those. But we have imported like nearly everything, and we can copy it here. So let me mark it here with my touchpad and click copy. And then we go over to the
ETS. Now it's in your clipboard, right?
Yes.
The groups that you used.
And now we can go here to our product, the Simbox Pro, to the secure interface. And we can add those group addresses here.
You have here a tab called Associations, right?
Yeah. Yes, I have the tab called Associations. And there we can add all the group addresses that are used inside the visualization. So we can verify it. Like we have the dimming group address here on the left, which is not used. And we see that it's not here inside this part because it's not used.
So only the groups that you actually used on the side of the visualization, those are now added here as an association to the secure tunnel. And
yes.
That's how you tell ETS, these are the groups that I actually need on the visualization. So all the filter tables on the topology, they are all then done automatically. Very, very
Correct.
Handy.
Very handy. And it doesn't only work on our product, like the secure interface on the Simbox, but if you used secure IP interfaces, you have tunnels as well, which you need to manage as well, like we did here. So you can use it on them as well. So you can just copy and paste them and add them onto the IP secure tunnel.
Yeah, that's the KNX approach, right? It works for all KNX devices that have an association or that have a secure tunnel. So the functionality is given for all.
Yes.
But we see here now that very quickly you could align your visualization with the ETS project, even though the ETS project doesn't know your visualization. Right?
So Correct.
This becomes very handy for visualization in secure projects. Yeah.
Yes. And the next part would be to export the interface information. So here are the keys. We would export the keys and add them into the visualization. So the visualization has all the keys to communicate securely. And then we would be set and would be, securely connected from the visualization to all the programmed devices through the ETS.
And you don't risk of sharing too many groups you don't need. You don't risk of clogging up the network. And so that's all very important, important, I would say.
Yes, maybe also one more thing to differentiate, because we have the export information here on the interface, which is also available on the IP interfaces. And this button here is the best opportunity to export only the group addresses that are really required for the visualization. So there's also the possibility to export from the project the security details here, the backup, the keyring. But the keyring has all the information, also the one we don't need.
For the entire project, yeah.
Yes, and if you use secure and unsecure group addresses, and maybe you have a proxy inside your project, then it may export the wrong information. So it might export you secure group addresses, but on your end, they are not secure, and the visualization would have the wrong information. So always, it's best to use this export here to have the appropriate key information for your project.
Very well said. Yeah, very nice. Well, thanks, Michael. I like this. You make good use of this new feature, the pasting of the group addresses. That's, like I said, also, it helps aligning this very quickly. And I'm glad you implemented this for 6.3. Very well.
Yes. We try to do it as easy as possible for our customers so they have a nice visualization product, which is fast and easy to use with KNX.
I saw that. Very good. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Well, enjoy 6.3 and enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you.